and also trusts herself near the table. This is the backhand bullet, that punch from Adriana that is quite effective when it comes into play, but it's a lower percentage shot.
If the sound wasn't different, you'd think she had short pips on it sometimes. But yeah, I think you summed it up nicely, Adam. She's got better close to the table. Attacking, I mean, if only you could win by flair against the Chinese, Adriana would have a much better record. So she needs controlled aggression mixed with flair, but not, she doesn't want to bring out her creative shots kind of whenever she wants. Maybe just in a case of emergency, or when she feels like it'd go against the pattern.
Nice recovery here. Wang Yidi withstands one of those bullet backhands and the net in the process. Wow. Must keep the racket wide open, or more so than usual, as there's less spin on it. Nice counter, good anticipation, knows the odds, makes her move and keeps the racket high. Watch the touch here, heavy spin comes in. Big follow through, but starts with the racket high.
That was smart play there. She didn't give Wang Yidi so much pace. She said, I want you to come over this ball. Wang didn't. And it allowed Adriana then to make time to play a bigger shot.
I'm sort of curious, as it's tied up here, Adriana's record against Chinese opponents, I don't remember it being one of the better ones.
I'll take a look for you in a sec.
Thanks.
You're so welcome.
But how? How well? No, I'm just kidding. Here we go. 4-3, Adriana Diaz in front by 1 point here. As Tong Tong watches on from the crowd. Beautiful counter, that serve right near the back edge of the table and taking a risk. This is one thing that Adriana Diaz's game is going to keep benefiting from, that close to the table speed counter and the confidence in that play.
That was the hardest angle she could have made from that position, and that's what it takes to beat Wang Yidi from that position. The level of shot you see from Adriana as a winner is credit to Wang Yidi in a way.
Right, it takes a good opening for the shot to come back to be impressive. Smashes against lobs are expected. Counters against rips that are low, not so much. But a good punch here. The pace from Wang Yidi to follow her serve ties it up. A taste of her own medicine, Adriana Diaz. Still, you could see good wrist action there, hitting it at the head of the racket towards the end. Ooh, little dribbler here.
5-6.
Adriana Diaz has not beaten a Chinese player in 16 meetings against them.
So just to clarify, this is since WTT started. It was still going. She got all of them back. Diaz was moving back into the table. This is just such an unlikely thing to have to deal with.
I mean, this recovery from Wang Yidi. Out the middle of that shot?
With a forehand nonetheless, she does it twice in a row. Whew. That's a lot of work for a point. That said, it's four in a row for Wang Yidi. Now, my personal limitations, I can feel the wrists stiffening up. It's such an uncomfortable ball to play after that ball comes back right at the baseline to your backhand side.
8-5.
Good behind the table, but smart on the parallel here. Wang Yidi takes advantage of a slightly more shallow shot, a little bit defensively coming in.
Nice side spin to put it away there. The top players can do that.
6 of the last 8 points to Wang Yidi.
6-9.
I love these ones, and watching them hit the ground when they're so spinny after they hit the net, and then they just sort of crawl forward like a motorized car. A wind-up toy even.
10-6.
But now, 4 game points for Wang Yidi. She was down 3-5. She's won 7 of the last 8 to be here. Nice angle there. Touch.
7.
I like the transparency of Diaz.
What do you mean?
You always kind of know what she's thinking.
Ah, yes, yes.
It's good for the sport, but might not be good of giving Wang Yidi any more confidence.
8-10.
What if? I mean, we saw Hugo Calderano last game. It's so, man, when you walk out of a great film, walking right into another theater, sometimes you just need to digest for a bit, sit on it. 2 game points left for Wang Yidi. And the step around forehand, Diaz.
See the tomahawk serve there? I can't say I've seen Diaz do that so often.
Definitely, she's got a bag full of tricks for when she needs them. She's got the windshield wiper and the crowd very sort of cautiously clapping on Wang Yidi. Tomahawk again and goes down the line a little off the top of the net. 4 points in a row, game points saved from Diaz after this serve switch with those 2 tomahawks. A bit of fortune, yes. Just the edge there. Alternating serves here. Flat hit back from the middle. Smart play here to pin the elbow there, Wang Yidi.
Marlin, Penhold God, a sensei of the sport, the China women's head coach. Former Olympic champion.
Game point to Wang Yidi. Again down the line, 2 bullets into the short side of the table. This is gutsy, really dangerous play from Diaz.
This is the thing, dangerous is the right word because it's dangerous for the opponent, but it's also a high risk shot to play.
Right. Nobody's safe at this point in time with the score like it is. This is the Adriana Diaz that makes the highlights time and time again. Second time I recall in this game alone. That wide forehand slapped back from behind the table. She's been chasing 6-10 down. And Diaz with a game point over her own. Backhand bullet punch does it, 13-11. And the pride of Puerto Rico gets her first game on the scoreboard. It's so deceptive, that pendulum serve, the way she comes into it, looking like it's going to be underspin and sort of pulls up on it at the point of contact. She looks freer to me and looser to me than she did in pretty much all of game one. Adriana Diaz, by the way.
Yeah, for sure. She doesn't look intimidated. I think that's the key thing. She's playing her game, and she has to. Nice there. She's playing the other side of the table with the push. Can hear the contact, the quality coming into that ball. Can still play a push aggressively.
As we saw there, that opening push, fast and long. A little bit behind the table to do it, but comfortable there. Slower backhand to start and then tested in the middle. Wang Yidi finding the crossover point. It's a very fine line there between that forehand and backhand.
1-4.
She's gone back to her usual serves, but those forehand tomahawk serves were working really well for Adriana, and I wonder why we haven't seen them this game.
I was surprised she went back to a pendulum serve to win the match. I thought, really? But then she pulled it off. This is one that on its way down catches the net. An unusual situation to favor Wang Yidi. And a similar shot here, just deeper on the table, and it carries long.
Yeah, it's a lovely shot. She's trapping the spin, coming down on the ball. Having to dig really deep here mentally to find some hope, Wang Yidi. Seems a little bit rattled.
Many are. It's funny, but I saw that statistic about 0-16 against Chinese players as we see a new serve here from Diaz. Backhand, it just comes a little bit long. I was going to say, I'd remembered Adriana Diaz beating Chinese opponents. But it was all before WTT. And the windshield wiper serve comes out, but Wang Yidi not fazed by it.
The only bad thing about that serve is that it takes a little bit longer to recover to a neutral position after you play it. But a lot of players still are not very confident receiving the windshield wiper.
Smart timing here. Gets one a little bit softer, capitalizes on the opportunity after Adriana Diaz tries to play the rhythm breaker here. Oh, what a flick! Man, it's almost offensive. I mean, it is very offensive, but no one's feelings should be hurt by this. Look at this, spanked right to the corner.
She didn't seem like she was in the best position to play the punch. It's an effective shot, but I feel like only when it really, really opens up for her.
Good D, it's on. Way back, she can keep the ball in play. Look at the spin, oh, it's carried long. A scooping shot from near the ground. The crowd loving some Diazi. That's Chinese for Adriana Diaz. It's her nickname. Ripped shot. That ball kicks. Oh, it caught the net on the way down. Flick again and then goes for a swaggy shot without turning the upper body quite as much. She's capable. Dominated last game, but Diaz, we know, capable of a comeback.
Oh, wow.
What an unusual recovery there. Plays some off-speed shots and manages to get away without a big finishing shot.
She gets the percentage perfectly there. And look, Wang Yidi's top spin came right back at her.
So first point to Adriana Diaz on the receive. It's a nice in-between length. You can feel the hesitation in Wang Yidi's attack in that rally. How much of that do you think is because Adriana Diaz has won a few points on that wide reach to the forehand?
Well, this is the thing. It's the beware of dog sign you talk about. You feel more pressure to make a winner against someone who you know is extra good in the defense game as well.
Wang Yidi handling a nice parallel shot coming in. Again, one of the most stable bases in the game.
She's kind of adopting a difference in the block here. She's putting the elbow higher and just guiding it through a little bit more.
Who's this you're talking about?
Adriana. I think Wang Yidi's expecting the punch, but Adriana is just slowing it down.
Interesting. Yeah, we have seen more change of pace from her. A nice through the legs catch attempt there. I think in general, though, if you're trying to beat anyone from the Chinese national team in the speed game alone, you're picking a fight with someone who's an expert in that domain.
Exactly.
As deep on the table as can be, specific placement, variation in the speeds out here. And you know she's got the bullet backhand. Adriana Diaz from the flat-hitting forehand, heavy spin when she needs it. If she's clever here, she's just going to have to keep it very unpredictable and change up. But she's doing a wonderful job so far this game. Trying to pounce on the opportunity.
Yeah, it was high enough to do that, I think.
For Adriana Diaz, I mean, she's made a high percentage of these shots. Several of them have come back. It's not like every time she hits it, it's a winner. Often yes against most yes. Clever idea to hug the table, turn and twist to go down the line.
Wang Yidi wants an easier job here on the third ball. So maybe we're going to see her serve with a little bit more float. or less backspin in general.
Good angle here on the punch. Wang Yidi takes it early from out in front, testing the wingspan of Adriana Diaz. And the patterns are so unpredictable. It looked like even in the replay, she was going to go down the forehand side on the shot before. Down by one on the serve. So stable on top of the table here with that quick backhand and still managing to generate spin with the wrist.
This is the thing, and this is why she's barely had any losses to anyone outside of Team China. It's that stability of Wang Yidi.
As short as can be on a short serve. I mean, this one, I think Wang Yidi was expecting something more half long. It's a bouncier serve, as you would say, that might mislead the receiver. Way back, the defense holds up for a bit. But Wang Yidi, again, not the tallest player in the world, still manages to come down on these lobs so well.
That short, snappy backhand, she can play it down the line, opens the wrist, opens the body, and just plays the inside-out forehand.
That was most impressive to me. Right to the corner, side spin just to keep it out of reach. Beautiful punch there. Were you thinking about the shirt point at all when you saw that just there?
The one with between Pitchford and Marlon?
Yeah.
A little bit.
In this rally, I wondered. Couldn't see it in that moment, but a beautiful punch from Diaz wins the point either way. Interesting. No acknowledgement at the top of the net, just a show. I think that's how much focus there is right now. Oh, that was cool. Says, yeah, that's cool, I'm on TV. I'll scratch my nose and continue my conversation. No problem. Nice turn. We've seen her win a lot of points this way as well, Adriana Diaz.
Serving into the middle with a bit of topspin there. Taste of the own medicine from Diaz. So Wang Yidi did that the point before, I think.
And we all remember that serve where Adriana Diaz got two bounces on the table. Outstanding play. The serve was quite unusual from Diaz with that big after motion. She seemed very fluid and in a rhythm throughout that point, but so did Wang Yidi.
Yeah, the rally blossomed beautifully. Short stroke to redirect.
Extra spin on the push. Diaz takes the chance.
Yeah, it was good spin on the push. I expected Wang Yidi to make it, but rushed into making the decision.
She sure was. Good placement there by Adriana Diaz. And this time, capitalizing on the baseline, the serves here will come back to Adriana Diaz at 9 points apiece.
Oh, that serve is stunning, isn't it?
It's one of those things that's just so well practiced as it just barely kisses the net but doesn't actually touch it to keep it as low as possible. All dimensions. Is it the tomahawk? Nope. So the windshield wiper with top and side, an outright point win.
She misread that like it was written in a completely different language.
Game point here, Adriana Diaz. Tries something similar, but a better read this time around on the page here. Wang Yidi sees it clearly and ties it up at 10 points apiece. Game number one, Adriana Diaz came back from 6-10 down. They will alternate serves here until one player has a 2-point lead. Heavy push once again in the placement. Wang Yidi second-guessing herself, it seemed, as she stopped to play the backhand instead of continuing to try to step around.
That was a much better push than she played before. She came round it a little bit. Daddy Diaz just giving her some reassurance there with his baseball cap on.
Stop. Backhand punch, and it's a 2-1 lead for Adriana Diaz against the world number 3. In what could be a massive win for Adriana Diaz, but still a long way to go. That serve is so deceptive.
Yeah, it's the after motion, isn't it? It's identical to the one that she just topspin with. Really got to have your eye on that contact.
Now, one thing about this flatter shot, the farther you get behind the table, the more difficult it is. It just doesn't have the arc. Adriana Diaz can still make it, but is going to want to be as close as possible in general when she takes it.
This is the thing. I mean, when we saw Trolls against Lim Jong-hoon at the Worlds playing those slaps from so far back, it was like, when have you ever really seen that before? It's the audaciousness. And Adriana, you could actually equivalent, I guess, the Trolls in some ways in the women's game.
I often do. I think their games have a fair amount of similarities in terms of the shots they play, their fearlessness,
3-2.
The creativity, the variety. Adriana Diaz here, take a look. Long serve right into the body at the baseline for an outright point. Good angle here.
Finally backhand. We're a fan of that.
Changing it up for the service placement, something new. And missing the contact on this one, Diaz surprising with the push.
I think he might have hit Wang Yidi's thumb there. I mean, it popped up in a really weird way.
Worked for Dima. Was it Dima who did it?
Yes, actually. I think he came off his finger, though.
Oh, right, I forget. Pluto's no longer a planet.
Indeed.
The thumb has been cast out of the finger category. No, a long time. I just slow to update. I don't read. Two points in front here, Adriana Diaz, with the serves back on her side. Loaded with spin. The racket speed on this one. You can feel the discomfort on Wang Yidi's side. I mean, even after last game, you knew this would be a tough match for Diaz to pull off, but right now it starts to feel like Wang Yidi, if she doesn't find a sense of belief and get back in her rhythm, this is going to be Diaz.
4-6.
That fine balance there. Again, takes this shot, and I think she has to from time to time. She makes a high percentage of that low percentage shot. That's what got her here in the first place.
I just can't help but think, Adam, I mean, Puerto Rico's entire population is probably less than China's playing population. Table tennis. This would be massive.
It would be. Adriana has done an outstanding job of putting Puerto Rico on the map. I mean, a superstar. The Diaz family is sort of like the Kardashians, but with athletic prowess and respect.
Well put.
Thanks. Tied back up, Wang Yidi. Said it once, I'll say it again, will not lie down here. The reason there is so much pressure and the expectations are so high is because they've done it and they can. The Chinese national team has no shortage of people to choose from. When you are chosen to represent China at this level, you've proven that you are able. And under pressure, that full stroke forehand, a lot of spin from Wang Yidi to secure the point.
If you're in front, you can feel the obligation to continue playing aggressively, and Wang Yidi has tied her up brilliantly here with shorter play to the net.
What a save! I thought the serve in the third ball was enough. Adriana Diaz goes back to that tomahawk serve, sets her up well, but 6 of the last 8 points now have been won by Wang Yidi. Ah, the humidity factor seeming to start to settle in. But you can see it here in this rally. Adriana Diaz is playing the wet ball game, playing just a little bit more cautiously, less spin. And Wang Yidi controls, takes advantage there of having Diaz behind the table.
Might have to use a little bit of extra forearm right now on those backhands.
Spinny opening, but Wang Yidi now with four game points. Same score line she had in game number one. It worked out in favor of the Utuaden. Adriana Diaz. Game point saved. That shovel serve to the backhand. Diaz fends one off. And the touch play goes the way of Wang Yidi, and we are going the way of game number five. Wang Yidi with the momentum, two games apiece. Right down the line, the blasting backhand. It's a fight, and it will be a fight to the finish here.
Sit tight and fasten your seatbelts. This could go either way right now.
Top edge of the racket, the deep push, surprising placement, and Diaz, clever as always. Good read on the serve.
She trapped the topspin.
Yeah, not easy to do. You don't see too many players successfully pushing topspin, but that was perfect. And the change of pace, softening it up. I feel tension in Wang Yidi right now.
No, for sure. She's not getting the kind of balls that she wants. She wants a clean game.
And invited to accelerate to add her own pace on the ball. That after motion once again. The pride of Puerto Rico with quite a start here. The neck tape can barely hang on. The fans trying to get behind Wang Yidi. Rallies are spectacular. Wang Yidi going toe-to-toe with Adriana Diaz behind the table. These exchanges, both wings. The flair, the physical fitness, the parallel forehand, this point is just so good to watch.
Poetry in motion, the timing is beautiful. She's trying to tire out Wang Yidi, Adriana, by making her have to make the pace. She's just putting the ball back with the backhand, not extending. Tried two there though, and Wang Yidi breathing down her neck.
It's interesting, Adriana Diaz has had points where she's made three of those bullet backhands in a row. The length of the table a little bit more secure. When she does make it down the line, it's been quite effective, but in that replay, you could see that Wang Yidi was gonna reach it if it came over the net. She was in a good position.
Left, 4-2.
Back to that shovel serve with the after motion. Looking for the heavy spin shot here, just trying to brush. And it's Wang Yidi with three in a row. There was almost no follow through on that serve. And still Wang Yidi with the perfect read.
This is a player, Wang Yidi, who has an 89% win record against non-Chinese players.
And four straight points back. Wang Yidi's got the crowd into it now. There's an encouraging lead, but safe. It's never safe until it's over. World number three, Wang Yidi, leveled out. After this point, they will switch sides. Question is, who will have the momentum? Clever idea, looking down at the racket. Adriana Diaz now down 4-5 on the other side of the table.
A high five in a row here.
5-4.
Goodness me.
I like the creativity on the receive. Sort of came in, took it right off the bounce. Could be jarring for players. Wang Yidi, a new level of focus for the last 5 points.
Yeah.
save from Wang Yidi, but there to clean it up. Adriana Diaz follows it and crushes it as needed in this moment.
Let's see this. She did well there, but there was still so much topspin on it.
Yeah, that's tough. Miyu Kihata with the roller last week.
Wow, that was something.
I feel like we've got two Adriana Diazes on the court right now. Wang Yidi not only blocks every punch in this rally, the ripping forehand on the parallel, but that big punch of her own to finish it.
These are balls you should not have to worry about coming back.
Exactly. But they do, they just keep coming back. She's got the racket high. Again, it's that fine balance, the risk assessment of when to spend the extra time on the stroke.
That was a very intelligent block because Adriana's momentum wasn't moving back to the backhand after she played the forehand.
So a 2-point lead here for a player who is down 0-4. So before this, Wang Yidi had won seven of the last 8 points, but Wang Yidi in trouble here as that spin shot comes in, and then the bread and butter. I mean, she was out of frame for a moment on camera, and by the time we came back, she was perfectly set up for that finishing punch. Kick serve. Long side and topspin from Wang Yidi to the backhand.
That's the kind of serve that's very hard to punch. She invited the attack straight away. Goodness me, this is an amazing match.
It is so tough. She couldn't change the pace the way she wanted to, but she found a way to win it. Adriana Diaz persistent on the parallels. Good coverage of the middle. Everything else, it took a lot here, but she kept Wang Yidi more responsive. Although the second to last shot from Wang Yidi really put some power behind it.
Yeah. Adriana gauged the distance well, though.
Deception once again. It's that pendulum serve, the most traditional serve in the game, but Adriana Diaz has won her fair share of points on almost every serve she has.
Yeah, she's bringing out the backspin in the tighter moments. If there's any nerves in your arm, it can almost seem to exaggerate the spin that you're up against and force an error. So you've got to stay relaxed, even in moments like this.
And a big point for Wang Yidi. She gets through the first backhand punch. 1 point lead here in a second serve. If she doesn't win this point, Adriana Diaz, whose service game has been strong. If we come back 9-9, I'd love to see the serve percentages for these two. Ooh, it almost comes down on the back edge. It is not over yet, despite the body language for a moment, Adriana Diaz. And here are the serve percentages. Less than half of her serves, she's won the point. Wang Yidi, if she can keep it on the table, has a 56% serving win rate. For me, that's just the open rally. In terms of serves that were straight up winners, no question about who's leading that category. What serve do you bring out in this moment? Oh, she's taken it! Wang Yidi pops up the service receive and still manages to take the match a big...